TAVI means transcatheter aortic valve implantation. It started in France and it's been every major Western and Asian country. So it's a process where we implant a new aortic valve, which is one of the main valves in the heart, through a catheter. And basically we can insert this catheter through the main artery in the groin and push it up into the heart and deploy the new valve in where the original valve is. And basically it's indicated for people with symptomatic but severe aortic stenosis, which is a narrowing of the aortic valve. Traditionally, treatment involves open heart surgery. It puts a lot of stress on the body, and we feel that in certain patient groups, they are much better off having a less invasive procedure. And these people would include those over 80, who we feel are clinically frail, or they have other health issues that might cause complications after they have their heart surgery. The way the procedure works, basically it involves passing a valve which is already pre-mounted onto a delivery system, and it enters through a femoral pulse or through a small cut in the chest, and we cross the diseased valve and deploy the new valve there. The procedure is done without bypass, so that means that the heart is still pumping, and once the procedure is completed, they can go to the ward the same day without having to go to intensive care.
For the community of Geelong, or in fact the Southwest Victoria, I think this is an exciting news, whereby such a procedure previously was only available in Melbourne. Now that with such a technology and service available in Geelong, it has certainly actually reduced the patient needing to travel all the way to Melbourne, and not only that there will be no financial cost incurred to the patient or the family. Patient actually will be assessed as a team approach, which is what we call a heart team approach, consisting of cardiac surgeon, interventional cardiologist, and a team of other specialists. And depending on the outcome of the assessment, we will make a best recommendation on patient whether they be best to have a TAVI or surgical or other means of improving the valve function. Claudia has been a patient of mine for the last few years because of her previous multiple vascular surgery that has put her into a significant worry in terms of how she's going to actually manage if she were to offer an open heart valve surgery. In addition to her clinical scenario, Claudia also liked to enjoy her gardening, and obviously that recently, because of her aortic stenosis, that she's no longer able to do that. So her case was discussed in our multidisciplinary heart team meeting, and because of the concern with regards to her recovery period, that will be felt that she'll be best to offer a TAVI.
I used to do a lot of bushwalking, and then that slowed down a bit because my husband died and I was by myself, so I wasn't walking, but I was still walking around the blocks and things like that. And then I started getting the pain in the chest. So I found that if I was doing a bit of heavy weeding or something like that, I could only do it for about 5 or 10 minutes before I'd have to come inside and sit down and relax, and then the pain would go away. First of all, I was just on tablets, but it didn't seem to, the pain was still there, you know. So we had different quantities of the heart drug I was taking. And then Dr. Chin decided that it was probably something else, and he x-rayed it and found that it was the heart valve that wasn't working properly. So they explained it all to me about how it was going to work, and I still wasn't very keen on having my chest opened up, but they said no, I wouldn't need to, that I could just have a keyhole surgery. And I still was a bit reluctant, but I said, what happened if I didn't have it done? And he said, it would only last for 2 years. And I thought, I needed a bit more life than that. So I decided that because it was only being keyhole surgery, I would only be in hospital for 5 days. So I decided I'd do it.
So Claudia actually had a procedure where we performed the operation through a tiny cut in the chest to access the aorta from the top. punctured the aorta and passed a TAVI valve through there. We felt that doing a TAVI is more gentle to Claudia, given other health issues, than a standard surgical aortic valve replacement going through the chest.
Because I didn't have such a big cut, I could easily just walk around and things like that. You know, it wasn't difficult and wasn't any trouble coughing or anything like that. I didn't have any trouble with that at all. I have more energy, I noticed. I've been walking with my daughter and it was just so much easier. I just felt so much better.
We're talking about 1.5 years down the track now, and she will have returned to her full activities that she used to enjoy and still doing well. And I think she'd be one of the good example whereby TAVI can actually make a significant improvement, not only just the symptoms, but also quality of life, allow her to return to her normal activities that she used to enjoy.